Hi there, my name is George Turner. I teach mathematics and I'm going to show you today how online mathematics tuition works when I tutor online. I'll tell you a little bit about myself towards the end, but I just want to show you quickly how the tuition works. Okay, so if I go to, now I normally use Google Meet, so let's just open this one up, I'm doing it all live. So let's just open up a new meeting, start an instant meeting. So I'd often send my student some work beforehand. There we go, there's me again. Okay, let's just cancel out here. So let's just get rid of the picture of me there, different picture of me. Okay, so I'd often send a student some work beforehand. So I just email them something. Hopefully I'd know what they're studying that week or what they're working towards in terms of an exam, so I can put something quick together, or I can figure out the resources which I'd want to use. So for example, this is one which I used recently, so let's show you this. So I just put together some questions from the EdExcel textbook here, and I just picked on some particular exam style practice because I knew this student was working through several chapters and particular topics from those things. So, you know, I looked at 11 pages I put together, really quick, but it enabled me then to be prepared at the start. And also, you know, my student can then say, okay, I find this thing difficult. I saw the stuff you sent me. I find this difficult. Can we focus on this? Or often students won't necessarily volunteer that at the start. So you'll have to just tease through and say, what about this? What about this? How are you feeling on this one? So in this case, I went through and picked out several questions, you know, so I picked out maybe, I knew the student was relatively competent. I picked out maybe this question here, and then I picked out a question in context. And then I tried to go through each of the pages, picking out a little bit here or there and trying to find out where the issues lied for the student. In fact, this is a student I know and I've worked with. This is the last revision session with them, but you can see that I often find something and send them it in advance, or at least I know what I'm going to pick on or where the resources are in advance. So you can see in another video of mine, for example, I like to use Maths Genie, Corbett Mathematics, Corbett Maths, Dr. Frost Maths, or exam papers as well. So those are really good things to share quickly. Okay, so how do we share them and how do we get the interaction going? So then if we have a look at going to, let's set up a Jamboard. So if we set up a Jamboard here, let's just move me across here. So start a new whiteboard. Okay, so it's creating a Jamboard which is associated with this Google Meet. Obviously I've invited the student to the Google Meet. And then I've got this, and then I can share a link to this with my student on the chat. So I'll copy the link here. There's my school, by the way, but I don't want people to be viewers. I want people to be able to edit this as well. So this is an online whiteboard, which we use and interact on while we're discussing things and while we're talking about questions. Okay, so we can obviously, now I can post a link to that in the chat. And of course you can see there's some chat here. I don't tend to use the chat. There's, what's the point in doing that when we can talk one-to-one, which is obviously what we do. Students may choose to share their screen, their image or not. Depends on whether you want that. I can also record these two, so I can just do a quick screencastify of each of these sessions and I can share that with you. I'd normally delete that within a week if there's a request for sharing, just so that I don't end up with hundreds of unnamed videos in my screencastify. But you can see, you know, if you want it to stay for longer, you can, it's no problem. Okay, but if you want me to share a copy of the entire session, I can. Okay. yeah, and if you would prefer that your son or daughter, or yourself, if you're the student watching this, if you would prefer that you didn't share your screen, that's okay as well. It's kind of nice to be able to see someone face to face, I think. So I always keep my image up in the corner. Okay, so what's the point of this Jamboard? Don't want to get to that. Where's my Jamboard? Jamboard's over here. Okay, so what's the point of this? Well, this is great because if I wanted to, let's go into something here. So maybe I want to have a look at, let's take this question here. So maybe I just want to have a quick, I think this question is good. Okay, so just copied that one across. And again, let's go to my Jamboard. I should need to close a few tabs, don't I? Okay, so there we go. I can just copy my question. I might know the questions in advance that I want to use, or I might be asking the student to kind of direct me a little bit as to which questions they'd want me to go through. And it may be that I don't have a question. It might be that I just go around, might start talking about a bit of theory. But when I put that up on there, the student sees it on their screen as well, of course. And when I start writing over this, so, you know, I might want to start writing over this. This has a nice little function here that I can do this. It will disappear. Okay, that's quite nice because it stops the page from getting messy, but students can see what I'm talking about. Okay, so if I want to say, well, you know, in this case, look, I've got this coordinate point and this coordinate point here. So, you know, I've got this one and this one. And if we're trying to, what are we trying to do? Find the gradient of the line. We can do that in different ways. Students might know about the formula. They might like to put things on a coordinate grid, in which case we can always go to, oh, this is nice. Let me show you this resource. So in which case we can always go to Desmos. This is a brilliant resource for drawing graphs. You know, if we put on y equals 2x plus 1, for example, we can put up coordinates on there which are on the graph. You know, you can see, for example, 1, 3 is on the graph. You know, and we can label those things. This is brilliant. You know, it's just another resource. There's tons of online resources, including some good construction resources as well. Really nice construction-friendly resources too. Anyway, going off on one. Let's talk about the Jamboard. When I write on this Jamboard, students can write on there as well. So if I do one line, a student can complete the next line. It helps if you've got a stylus or a pen, an electronic pen, which you can write on your iPad with. I'll often keep another, open up the Meet on my iPad as well. And if I've got this going on my iPad at the same time, then I've got an iPen and I can write over things there. My handwriting is nice and neat then. And you know, students can just write on their screen, hopefully if they have an interactive screen, or using their iPad, or the worst comes to the worst, they can, if they don't have a pen, they can use their finger. So for example, here we go. Look, you can see I can use my finger here as well. Okay, it's pretty easy to do. Or, you know, worst comes to the worst, they can use their mouse. But I suggest getting something interactive, and a pen is really good. The iPen, the Apple Pencil, in fact, the Apple Pencil is extremely good because you can rest on your iPad at the same time as writing. Okay, I don't want to say too much more. That's roughly how it works, and you get a sense of who I am as well here. The good thing is here, once we move on to each next page, you know, you can copy and paste more questions. You can do whatever you want on these things. The good thing is then I can download this afterwards, so I can just download a PDF of all of my screens there, and that's something I can share with a student or share with parents as well. Okay, in fact, I would always share it with students, but parents might want to see it too. Okay, so that's basically how it works. If you're interested, contact me on Dubai Maths Teacher. Let's write this on our Jamboard. Okay, so we're talking about Dubai. Okay, so I'm not Sony when I'm writing with my finger. Dubai Maths Teacher at gmail.com. Okay, so there's my email address. You can get in contact. I've been tutoring for years, so a little bit about me. I've taught in the UK. I've taught in several different schools in the UK since 2000, 2001. I trained in 2000. I moved to Dubai in 2016. I've worked in the same school since. I look after IB mathematics as well, so I set the exams for that. I, you know, liaise with parents and all the students who do IB mathematics. I teach from year 7 upwards to year year 13. So mostly I teach the older students these days, but I teach the whole range of students. I often teach a foundation set in IGCSE. So, you know, I'm pretty patient kind of guy. I teach that because on the other end of the scale, I teach the HL mathematics, both the AA and the AI course at IB. So, yeah, you can see how it is. Contact me if you need any, if you're interested at all. Clearly, it's you can get a lot done in an hour. Tuition can make a real difference. It generally helps if you do it. Obviously, I'm going to say this, but it helps if you do it repetitively. So if you do an hour a week, it's a really focused amount of time. And I think it's probably something like four times more efficient than working on your own. So it's a really efficient, intense session, but hopefully relatively fun as well. You know, I'm not a complete Grinch. In terms of payment, in terms of cost, so the standard the tuition has cost in Dubai since I've been here is 300 dirhams an hour. That's for key stage three, so year seven through to year 11. Sometimes tutors charge a bit more for IB. It depends on how much preparation is required. For some of those, some preparation could be required as well. From my point of view, the fact that I don't have to go to people's houses when I'm doing online tuition means that I can offer a little discount. And if people want to pay in advance for multiple sessions, then, you know, if it's like 10 sessions, we can do like 10% off. So, you know, it's, you know, just trying to keep things fair, but also, you know, you know, there you go. What more to say about the money, really? You're welcome to come and see me if you live in Dubai. Come and meet me. Or if you live nearby, I can come and meet you as well. As a sort of one-off, I exclusively do online tuition now. I find it to be really effective, but also I've got a little baby son, so it's kind of difficult to drive off somewhere in the evening and not be back in time for his bedtime, you know. In terms of the payment, you can do a transfer, you can do a BACS, just a bank transfer. You just need the IBAN number for that. I have an international account as well, so just asked that it would go in there. Okay, sorry to talk money, but you know, it's probably something that you'd like to know. Okay, thank you very much. Again, any questions, contact me here. And yeah, I've got another video which I made just before this one as well, talking about some maths resources. I talked about Corbett Maths, Maths Genie, Physics and Maths Tutor, which I'm not associated with, but they have fantastic past paper resources there. And I talked about Dr. Frost Mathematics there as well. I'm going to stop it there. Thank you very much. And I welcome any contact. Okay.